Her name is Mrs. Patricia Osawe, a mother who is in serious anguish and needs your help under emergency. His name is Collins Osawe, son to Mrs. Patricia. He is completely insane for good 11 years running. Please, this video contains visuals that might be unpleasing to sight. Therefore, viewer's discretion is advised. But for the sake of saving humanity and a brother who was once normal but now currently insane, be patient as we find solution together. Let's now get the story from the very beginning.
I've been in many places because of my son, which is masked for 11 years now. This year make 11 years. Last year it was 10 years. No help from anywhere. My husband is late for 16 years now. So nobody to care. Even the 5 minutes, I don't have anybody to help. Somebody directed me to Godsent that he helped people. And me, I see that through actually helping people, I said, okay, my help will come here. So I'm suffering, even to itself, it's difficult for me. I have to go around and seek care for people. I don't know where to run to, so I believe that my help will come from this place.
Her tears, emotions, and pains didn't even convey her bitter story very well. But Godsent Foundation have professional staff who are experts in evaluation and problem analysis. After a proper round table and online consultation with the Godsent himself, Ambassador Dion Osage, the next day, Doe TV and Godsent Foundation crew set out on a journey in Benin City, Edo State, Nigeria. Patricia Osawe, in excitement and with sense of relief, received the crew. Now, this is the story. This abandoned and dilapidated house is where Mrs. Patricia, her daughter, and two sons shelter in one of the flats. Why the remaining flat is just for one of her sons, why the crew visited. Meanwhile, this house is alleged to belong to Mrs. Patricia, but after the death of her husband, the documents were forcefully collected from her. Everywhere is bushy and unkept. No door, no window, the roof is leaking, and when it rains, water occupies the flats. Everywhere is smelling. The wall and the floor is a complete shadow of itself and very sticky and has a pungent smell. Guess who lives here? Mr. Collins Osawe, son of Mrs. Patricia Osawe, who has been insane for complete 11 years counting. He is completely naked, very hostile, and could hurt anyone who cares to clothe him. Only his mother that he is friendly with, and only her could feed him. He is chained so he could be in one place instead of roaming around the streets, eating waste from waste bin and gutter. What does Mrs. Patricia want from Godsent Foundation?
I want them to help me for my son, to take him to psychiatric hospital, Selu. What we need before, if they say 250, but now, nah, as everything don't cost, now if he reach 350 for Selu.
How does the mother feed him in the last 11 years? Read the inscription on the paper she's holding. She begs from house to house, shops to shops, street to street, market to market, at her age, just to have a son alive, even though he is insane.
I will enter store to beg, please, may I help my son. I show them the picture. If not 10 naira, anything you get, you give me. If not rice or beans or garri, anything you see, may I help me. Make I take go feed her. Because I don't have money to be selling something. I don't have money to trade.
Mrs. Patricia needs over 350,000 naira to take her son to psychiatric hospital where he will stay and receive medical care, which is also very expensive. Some money was given to her, and a promise of constant financial support for feeding and upkeep was also pronounced.
God bless you. I don't have anywhere to go. Thank you very much. Your God will continue to bless you and your family. In Jesus' name.
In conclusion of the story, Mrs. Patricia and her son, Collins Osawe, received the first step of her story, changed from bondage to freedom. her son has been taken to the psychiatric hospital, Benin City, with all bills, welfare, currently footed by Godsent Foundation and partners.
I will lift up my eyes to the hills from where comes.
Good afternoon, sir. Yeah, good afternoon. Good afternoon, followers and viewers of Godsent Foundation. My name is John Agberebe, social worker at Godsent Foundation. We are live at Igbo-Winner Federal Neuropsychiatric Hospital to see Collins Osawe. He's here with us. We were supposed to go live in the hospital, but they said the new normal of the hospital, which is their new policy, does not allow that. So we have been actually running around to make sure we actually make it live here. At the end of the day, I was able to make sure he was granted a parole. So here he is, and our aim is to ask him some questions to make sure to know how far he's doing. Collins, how about it? Talk, come on, maybe they hear you.
Collins, how far now?
Don't talk to you. Okay. What's the talk to you? Answer around.
Collins, how far? You know my name?
I don't know
your name. Okay, my name is Dion Osage. Now me they pay your hospital bills since we take this psychiatric hospital for the past 3 months. Now we they pay your hospital bills. See my face. In case you want to know my face, now my face be this. Is you see me?
Okay,
thank you, sir. Now my face be this, okay? How your body they do you now?
Did you ask me?
Okay, let's just take him around a little bit. If you have some money there, take him to buy him some chicken. Take him to Mr. Biggs, close to the office. Let's just drive him around so I can get a feel of the city and also feel refreshed. Open the car windows so that the air can blow his head.
Okay, sir.
All right,
sir.
We'll control. Just bring him. Just take him around. Okay, it's all right.
Okay, sir. All right, sir.
All right, Godsent family. You remember the case of Collins Osawe, who was chained up for more than 10 years. All right, he was chained up for more than 10 years in his house because he had a mental issue. You know, these things is not what we pray for. We don't pray to be in these kind of situations, but these situations can happen. It can happen to you. It can happen to me. It can happen to our family members. So we've been able to send Collins Osawe. This is Collins Osawe you are looking at, the same person I just showed you. This is the same person. We are sent to the psychiatric hospital for the past 3 months. We have been footing the bill to see how we can be able to assist this young man to see a better day.
There's a hero. If you look inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of what you are. There's an answer. If you look within your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. And then a hero comes along with the strength to carry on.
Okay, so that's Collins Osawe, you know, a young man from Eastern Land, who is suffering from mental health for 11 years. He was chained in his house when we went to rescue him, and we have been able to make impacts. Okay, so Godsent Foundation family, I could have not been able to achieve this without your support. Thank you so much for being a source of hope to so many families.
Yeah, good afternoon, lovely partners of Godsent Foundation. It's another beautiful day here in the city of Benin, and it's another fulfilled day for every one of us who have actually been pursuing this course from the very first beginning. We want to say a very big thank you to everyone who said a big thank you. As you can see, Collins is doing very well. He's doing very well, although, you know, he's also going to take time before he starts talking out. He's actually appreciating from here, just that he can't speak out very well. He's very fine, and we are on our way to the shelter now.
Help you push your dream is better. So right now, you can see Collins coming out of the vehicle. Okay, that's my man, John. That's my man, John, over there, doing an amazing job. Social worker from the University of Benin. As you can see, we had to hire a car all the way from Igbo Bahil. all the way to my side in Edwina. And yeah, this is our free shelter. You know, created this building for people to be able to live here comfortably. All right. So after spending 11 years in chain, Collins is now carrying his own bag. Can you imagine? Collins was so violent. He was so violent. Today he's able to carry his own bag. Is it that not God? Mama Collins.
Sir.
Are you happy now?
I'm very, very happy, sir. Very, very happy and grateful.
You're happy now?
Yes, sir. God bless you, sir.
Collins, how are you?
Stay fine. Stay fine, sir. Sir, I'm very grateful, sir.
Collins, how are you?
Stay fine, sir.
Collinzo. Collinzo. That's my brother. I love you so much, okay? I love you, okay? Don't worry. I'll do everything possible to help you out, okay?
Yes, sir.
This is Collins. Now and before. Can you see the difference? Okay, John, give us update. Give us update on everything.
Okay, sir. Good afternoon, boss, and good afternoon, wonderful partners around the world. We are live at the WIN Women's Shelter provided by a Godsent Foundation to the less privileged who do not have a home to stay. This is Collins Osawe, the mental challenge individual that we intervened in his case in February 2021. And we pick him up at his residence at a very stark state of his well-being, you know, was stark naked. We took him up from his home and we took him straight to the neuropsychiatric hospital. And for over since we have been responsible footing his bill over there at the hospital. And that is a wonderful thanks to all our partners around the world, that if it weren't you, it wouldn't have been possible. Now today, the doctor has confirmed on him that he is fit to leave the hospital, although he'll be going back for checkup and he's still on his medications and drugs. So today he's here at the shelter provided by Godsent Foundation, which is going to stay for the period of 2 to 3 months while we evaluate his case. And then we can decide to rent a suitable apartment that is suitable for them, for himself and the mother, where he can start living his normal life.
So the doctor has confirmed that he is fit to go home, right?
Exactly, sir. He has confirmed on him that he is fit to go home. That is why he was discharged today. Although he was going to be going for checkup next 4 weeks away from now. And his drugs were actually administered to him, which is going to be taken at home. So he's going to have a fresh atmosphere of the society right here in the Women's Shelter, away from the hospital. And I believe it is also going to help in his mental development. It's also going to help in his health and all other ramifications of his life.
Show him his room and, you know, let's go back inside.
Okay, sir.
Let's take them to the room in the back. Two of them. All right, so those two rooms, the Collins can have one room and the mom can have one room.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much for your gracious self, sir. Very beautiful afternoon, Monday afternoon to every one of us watching, wherever you are. God bless you, everyone. Thank you very much. We are live at WIN Women's Shelter here at Oluku. We are on a follow-up case to see our very old man, Collins Osawe. My name is John Aguirre, social worker. All right. Thank you very much for joining us. It was very, very interesting to walk into this place this afternoon, seeing Collins in a very good, manner and a very good mental well-being. It is very, 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 very commendable to every individual and every partners that has made this very, very possible.
I want to say God bless all of you. God bless you all richly for all that you have been doing for this young man. Thank you very much for bringing him from the state of nowhere to put him to the state of awareness. You know, it was actually on the state of where he doesn't know where he lives in his own world, but now he now lives among the society. Thank you very much, Godsent family. Thank you very much, Godsent Foundation. We are here to actually see how he is doing outside the mental health facilities and to also give him some funds to keep him going for the next week. So God bless you all richly for joining us today. I will say thank you very much for joining us. Collins, how far now? Talk, you come out. You want to be the job yours now? They smile. So, how did you enjoy this place outside the place on your first day? You did enjoy the place? Okay, thank you very much for agreeing to the truth. This is Mama Collins.
Good afternoon.
She want to say a very big thank you for all we have been doing for this family.
God bless you.
All right. Thank you very much, family. Flo, outside just sitting in one place and sitting inside. So let's see how it will look like on this scale of running a marathon with Collins. Collins, how far show? So, as you can all see, my guy is fully ready with his joggers. I asked him to dress in this manner. So he's on his joggers, ready to do some exercise. Collins, are you ready? Collins, are you ready? One, two, ready, go. Not before. One, two, yeah. One, no. Go. One, two, three, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52. She beat the other one, I tell you. You feel it, 1, 2, 3 for me. Yeah? You feel it, 1, 2, 3 for me. Okay. Yeah, let me hear it. Read, come out. Say they hear me now, they say one. Oh yeah.
Two.
Two.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Continue.
51, 52, 53, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100.
We don't know. As you can see, Collins is fast approaching the state of mental wellness. You know, mental wellness is fast approaching it. Is doing really much better than what it is, the mental facilities, you know. Thank you very much, Godsent families, partners, sponsors worldwide. Want to say a very big thank you. Please do well to support the Godsent Foundation anywhere that you are. This is a man who we have picked up from a very dehumanized environment. You need to see that place. You need to see where he lives, you know. even animals can't stay there. That was where a Godsent Foundation picked him from and take him to the mental health facilities where all his bills, all the bills and all the treatment payment has been paid and made by a Godsent Foundation and its partners. It hasn't been easy all this while, but persistence has paid off. Persistence in the sense of finance. It has been you have been there for us, financing this boy's head from the day one. We have spent a lot on this boy, and it has been you. Please, I want to keep soliciting that we shouldn't leave him at this particular early stage. He needs more support. He needs more support to get him going, you know. It has, meanwhile, Mama Collins, this one on a weekly money, when my God say make a give on. You see, this money and the weekly money my God say make a give on, one I want to use for the next period until I come back. Yeah, so now 10,000 naira. I say make a give you. So, Collins, I want to hand over this money to not be your mama. I leave my guy. You understand? But I talk nothing. Please, talk nothing again. Please. Oh yeah, my like me. Bad guy. So Collins, when you don't hold money rich? Yeah? Okay, this is another area that we need to concentrate on right now. You see, for the past 11 years, this young man has not had money in his hand. You know what that means? And the first money touching his hand is coming from a Godsent Foundation. Godsent Foundation, respect. Thank you very much. You know, this is the first time he's handling money, and this is a sum of 10,000 naira that will be handed over to him that the mom is going to be using to take care of some little stuff till we get back to them. Collins, this is the first time money is touching your hand in the past 11 years. This money, as it touches your hand, it will also react to your mental well-being, to your whole body, to let you know, say, you now belong to the society which every one of us lives. You understand? You now belong to our society. You understand? You are not going to be stigmatized. You are not going to be isolated. You are not one of us. You understand? So, a Godsent Foundation and its partner loves you, and they want you to do far better than you are right now. And they want to see you do very much better. Yeah? So, this is the money from the Godsent Foundation. They are handing it over to you. So, say thank you to the Godsent Foundation and its partner. Speak out now. Tell them thank you. Finish now.
Thank you.
Say God bless you.
God bless you.
Richly in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Say God bless you in Jesus' name.
God bless you. Jesus.
All right. Collins Osawe, my very own guy. Say thank you very much and God bless you in the name of Jesus.
I love you all.
Aside, and you know you can survive. So when it feels like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong. You will finally see the truth that a hero lies in you.